It's Wednesday, 13th of March. I've got a couple of days left of the season. I've just finished work. I've just got down to my peg. I'm just basically down at Helston Mill. I'm going to have a quick 2 or 3 hours. So it's 4 o'clock now. I'll probably give it to about 6:30, 7 o'clock. I'll quickly show you around. I'm just right near the mill. Probably give it an hour or two here, and I might just try another peg further down. But I've literally just ruffled a bit of bait together this morning. I've got worms, a few worms in there. Got a few slices of bread. Got a bit of terminal tackle in there. Got some 4mm pellets if I need it. It's got a bait box. I just made up a bit of ground bait. Pinkies, squats, and I've got some sweet corn, luncheon meat, and a bit of cheese paste. And down there, we've got some dead red maggots, just in a bit of water so they don't go black. I'm just gonna start off the way I finished the other day. It's got a size 10 animal hook, 4 or 5 red maggots on there. So I can fill the feeder and cast it out. I'll probably be looking to go close to that tree, overhanging the tree that's in the water. But I'll see what the flow's like. I've just got a 35 gram Camazon black cap feeder. But I'll see what the flow's like, see if we're holding. Let's get this out. It's not holding at all. It's just going to bounce around near the tree, so stick on a heavy feeder. A bit jungle warfare. I'm going to have to go as far right as I can. Right, take two. I lost my hook link. Yeah, I'm just going to try a different spot. I'm just going to cast into the middle channel. Seems like a little bit of a slack area. I'm just going to try it out. If not, I have to go resort back to my normal. I'm just going to try a worm. See if we get anything on worm. Unfortunately, it's about the only place I can cast and hold the bottom. Just literally at the end of the first run there. I thought the wood, the bites have slowed up a little bit after the initial sort of half an hour. Really wish I had some heavier feeders or some flat leads or something. Flat calm on the other side, but you cast over there and it just absolutely belts around, bouncing. I say if I leave it too long, I'm going to be behind, left of the tree, and that's it. But unfortunately, it's tackle everywhere, and people are being down, and bits of rigs here, there, and everywhere. Carp rigs, I don't know what they're doing in here. Okay, I've just tied on a new hook link, slightly shorter, but still sticking to 6 pound hook length, and I put on a Amazon B525. Size 14 hook. I've had a good cast around. I've got a 2.5 ounce feeder on, but further out there, for some of them reasons, it doesn't look like it. It looks pretty slack, and it also, you know, it looks like it's flowing back up, but it's not. It's just wanging around. Don't think I've got any heavier feeders, but if I leave it too long, the line and the feeder's going to get dragged around the tree, and I'm obviously going to lose it. So I've just had a cast about without any bait, and I'm just literally underarming it off the end of the run. There's a deep run inside here. It's almost where the end branch is. It's feeling the end of the ripples. So I'm just gonna have a bit of a rethink. I mean, I want to get across the other side because that's, I know where the chub and that are. I'll just give it 15-20 minutes on the inside down here. If nothing, I might have to move swims, I think. There's no signs here of any roach or dace or anything. As well, there's so many snags in here, there's so many old ironworks and all sorts of bits and pieces. There must be thousands of feeders and rigs out there. Years ago, I know that there's some people doing some survey work diving down here, and he said there's where the old mill is, there's loads of great big sticking up bits of metal. And there's a real, years ago, further on one side, there's a real big snag there. You wouldn't get a bite from the chub or barbel unless you went over it, but the chances of getting one out was like 1 in 15, 1 in 20. Because even if you sat on your rod and held your rod, as soon as you had a bite, it would be straight in there. But I might have to move my bank stick to over there and sort of like fish from over further to my right. But I'm just feeling my way in. I'm not putting too much bait in, just for a little bit of ground bait and a few deads at a time. I don't know how much is in here, if there's anything left. So I'm not going to go gun ho. But I can try worm, I've got sweet corn. I might just start putting a few 4mm pellets through as well. Just chucking a few 4mm in. Do for now. I was almost tempted this morning, just ran out of a bit of time before work. I was going to pick up a big chub afloat. I thought, it might be worth a trot through, and I wish I had now. You can get right up near the wall in that corner bit, get the tricky walk round, and you can stick floating down. Or a big chub with like six one shot. Five or six AA bolt down the line. And there's a deep gully on this inside. Years ago, when this all used to be gravel, you thought if I stepped in there now, I'd be up to my knees in silt. So that used to be a big gravel bar running all the way out. And there's a gully that runs all the way through. It's like a deep channel, so about 3 or 4 foot deeper on this inside. It runs through as it starts to shallow up. I mean, this should all be natural stone and shingle, but it's so silted up now. Okay, I've had three little minnows. I've just put size 14 on and three maggots. And it's had a big slam down on the inside there and the hook was gone again. That was twice it's happened. So there's a little jackpike in there taking maggots or maybe a trout or something. So I've just had another hook on, we'll give it another go. There's fish there, they're biting. It's an eyed hook, but I'm tying it on with the spade end tie, because I think you get a better knot. We'll try a bit of bread flake. Another little minnow on a worm. That's about six now. Seems to be all these and not much else. This peg's getting really a bit precarious now, slipping and sliding everywhere. Okay, I've had three little minnows. I just put size 14 on and three maggots. And it's had a big slam down on the inside there and the hook was gone again. That was twice it's happened. So there's a little jack pike in there taking maggots or maybe a trout or something. So I just had another hook up, we'll give it another go. There's fish there and they're biting. It's an eyed hook, but I'm tying it on with my spade end tie, that's going to get a better knot. Thank you. to go a bit easy. Now, the more movement around, the wetter the peg's getting, and it's a bit precarious. I've had another few casts further out here that I never had. No baiting, it's just a seaver. You know, I can't hold. It's about 4:45, time's pushing on, so I put a banded 8mm pellet on. I'm just going to load up the feeder with some pellets and sit and wait for a bite. I've had about 7 or 8 little minnows. I don't see any point. Tried worm, tried maggot, bread, sweet corn, just getting minnowed out. So, got a load of 4mm ground bait. Size 10, Amazon, animal, 8mm banded pellet. I'll get this chucked out. Right, just cast that out. Put the bait runner on this time, just in case. I'm going to get my hat, get my torch, and we'll get back to you. I'll leave it running. Thank you. that's a nice evening. It's nice and warm, still well, when I left work it's 15 degrees. Show me about the flow. It's been a perfect evening. The guy said last week, the river was up to here, nearly flush with the road, so dropped a lot, but still pulling through hard. Thing is, well, this peg right in front of me, or just to the left of the tree, must be a bit of a branch or something underneath the water, or feel it grating on the hook link. Two or three times I've been snagged in it. Managed to get it back so far, but I'm sure any wily chub will know exactly where to bolt. From years of experience, I know they tend to hang out further across the other side. I mean, I've had them in the middle before at night, in the summer and that. But we'll persevere here. I don't think I'm going to move. I might give it a little bit longer, till about 7 o'clock. I've got the floodlight. You never know, might just be a totally different animal after dark. I'm glad I made the effort now. Really glad I made the effort. I know we've only had about 6 or 7 little minnows, but with tomorrow night and that's it really.
Okay, what I thought I'd do is fishing with a banded 8mm pellet, say size 10. Animal hook. I've got some cheese paste I made the other day. Just gonna wrap a bit of cheese paste for a bit of smell. Mold that around the pellet. Perfect chub bait. Plenty of 4 mils. Some ground bait. Jungle warfare here. Just wash my feet.
just cast out firm on the inside. I know, I remembered I used to get some chub before. Just underarm flicked it towards the weir in this deep pool here. There's a tree to the left. Just turned round, coffee, and the rod was off the rest. Missed it, pulled out. Damn it. Right, I've got to be a bit more vigilant with my rod. The bait's alright, but the rod was going and going and going, it didn't let go. There we go. That's a beast of a chub. I don't know if you can see this, guys. Carl's got an absolute clonker of a chub. Absolute clonker. That's the biggest chub I've ever caught, I think. I'm gonna go get there. Scales for this one. Hook still in the bottom of his mouth. Careful with this, it's on the landing net. Look at that, guys. What an awesome, that's so fat. I'm gonna go get the scales for that. Pellet still in his mouth. Cheese wrapped in blue cheese paste. Let's get a few pictures of this. Right, bit of disgorger. Got the unhopping mat here. Get that out of the way. Oh, probably get the. His mouth's so big. The hook's right in the bottom lip. I'm gonna go get the scales for this one. Hook's still in the bottom of his mouth. Careful with this, it's on the landing net. Look at that, guys. What an awesome, that's so fat. I'm gonna go get the scales for that. Pellet's still in his mouth. Cheese wrapped in blue cheese paste. Let's get a few pictures of this. Right. Right, I'm going to put them in the net, let them rest, and then I'm going to give them away. Okay, he's just resting in the net. Just going to find some scales. Result. Okay, let's get this put back. It's well rested. Look at that. Thought it was a carp. I'll just show you it quickly like this on the side. Alright, let's get him back. What a result, all back. All right, let's get that out again and do the same again. Pellet wrapped with blue cheese paste. I'll get that cast out into this deep pool here. Just gonna get a few pellets catapulted out there. Sort this rig out. Pellet. Absolutely honking. Stilton blue cheese paste. Just getting a bit like that. Flattening it out into. Wrapping it around the pellet. Just enough like that. So the hook. Just going to stick with pellets now. Pellets and ground bait. Well, one's enough for me, that's what we came for. But I'm greedy, let's try for another one. I'm not going to put the bait runner on. I want the rod right close to me here. You see that tip all right? I think I've got a lamppost just to the right of me here, lighting up the tip nicely, so I might just stay a little bit longer. Well, the big chub are still here. It's always the same. You've got to wait till the light goes before they come out of their haunts. Well, what a hunch to just not go home today. Got up early this morning for work. Sorted my bait out quickly, dug some worms. I had my gear in the car anyway. Just come down here. Little pool there. But that rod tip will absolutely just go and go and go. I'm not going to put the bait runner on. I'm going to leave this running, hopefully he can get a bite on camera. Okay, it's 6:30. Probably going to give it another half an hour. Might have an inquiry. We'll be right back. actually quickly bring this in and cast it a bit further out. Where was that?
What's holding in there? Just in that slack?
Yeah, slack water there.
Yeah. What's holding about 50, 60 grand?
Yeah, about 60 grand, but I can't even hold up there with about 2.5-3 ounces. Well, what a hunch to just not go home today. I've gone up early this morning for work, sorted my bait out quickly, dug some worms, I had my gear in the car anyway, just come down here, little pool there. But that rod tip will absolutely just go and go and go. I'm not going to put the bait runner on. Hey guys, it's 10 to 7. I'm going to give it another cast, I think, and then unfortunately, not that I want to call it quits. Been at work all day, I was up at 5:30. I've not eaten yet, not had any dinner. Getting hungry. Got to get back, have a wash, work tomorrow. I'm going to get this cast in, hopefully. Exactly in the place that I want it. It's a little deep hole. Just, you probably won't be able to see it. It's a tree to my right. Nice deep hole there. Right, what I'm going to do is, sorry about the light. Okay, what I'm going to do is give it 10-15 minutes. If I catch something, you'll see it. If not, hope you enjoy the video.
Okay.
I'm just speaking to a couple of guys, he's been up there.
It's the next peg.
He had three little chub.
He said that's an absolute stonker.
So, yeah, enjoy the video. Any comments, get back to me.